Hi guys, welcome or welcome back to my channel. I'm Cammie and this is Cammie's Closet. If you're new to my channel, thank you for coming and please subscribe so you could watch all my videos as I post them. If you're not new to my channel, thank you for coming back. I had a few requests for different videos, so today I wanted to do a what fits in my Fendi Baguette. I have not used this bag yet, so I'm not going to do a review, but I'm going to do a quick what fits, and I'm going to do a little bit of a mod shot with the straps that come with it and two other straps that I have that I purchased not for this bag, but I'm just curious to see how it's going to look. So very quickly, I'm going to show you what fits first, and I brought a couple of different things here because I don't always carry all these things, but I wanted to interchange to give you guys an idea. So I'm gonna start with obviously showing you that the inside has a zip pocket on the back and the inside is a material, it's not leather. I don't have an insert for it, which I'd like to get, but you know, when you get an insert, it makes the inside smaller. So let's just start right away by putting my phone in because obviously that's one of the most important things I carry. So my phone, and I'm gonna say my LV Zippy wallet if I'm gonna carry a regular size wallet as opposed to a card case. So we'll start with the phone and the Zippy wallet. Next, I always have a little pouch with like hand sanitizer and a chapstick. So I'm gonna put that in there. That fits on the side over there. It's kind of hard to see. My mini readers, if you know me and you watch, you know I don't go anywhere without these. I have to be able to see tags and receipts and sizes and menus. So I'm going to put that right in the side. Goes in with no problem. Let's say I'm going to take my lipstick. So this is my bougie Amazon lipstick case. I'll put that in, no problem also. So far I have everything in here. Goes right in with no problem. Of course, keys. Now, I don't like to keep my keys in without being in some kind of case because I don't want it to ruin the inside of the bag. The flap of this is leather. The inside isn't, but I don't want to ruin the inside. But let's just say I use my YSL key pouch. Will that fit in there? It can fit in there with the keys. Will it close? Yeah, it actually will. So that's a pretty good amount of things in here. You know what? My Chanel mirror. That easily goes in also. So now I have a Zippy wallet, my phone, my YSL keys, the pouch with the keys, the mini readers, the pouch with the hand sanitizer, and a mirror. It closes right up with no problem. It doesn't even look bulky. It looks perfectly fine. Looks great. The only thing I didn't put in here was a small bottle with Tylenol and Motrin. I don't necessarily have to take that with me. And here's the card case, but I would only use the card case if I'm not going to use the Zippy wallet, right? So let's leave that out. If I put the card case in here, then of course there's you know, much more room. And if I want to take the Tylenol with me, that goes right in also with no problem. Closes right up. It holds a lot, this bag. It really holds a lot. So let me just show you. It has a top handle. We know that it has a top handle. Everybody knows that. You've probably seen this video 1,000 times and you could see it 1,000 more times. If everyone is aware, it comes with a long strap, but this strap on most people is too short to be a crossbody. Usually people are wearing that as a shoulder strap or they add an extension, because if you're broad or you're very tall, it's not going to work. And I don't know why Fendi would do that. I think that was really absolutely thoughtless of them not to make a crossbody strap on a bag of this price point. It's just ridiculous. However, for me, because I'm only 5'1" and I'm also, you know, small framed, I could wear this as a crossbody pretty easily. I'm going to show you. But if I'm wearing a very big, thick winter jacket, it might not work so much. So let me show you how it looks. This is how it would be on the shoulder, right? Looks good. This is how it would be crook of the arm with the strap hanging. And if I put it crossbody, it comes up kind of high. Like I said, with a heavy, thick down jacket, it might not work. But for the summer, for the spring, I can get away with it. It's about 3 inches under my boob. Is that comfortable for everybody? I don't know. I can do it. I feel okay. It feels comfortable to me. I don't have a problem with this. I think it's okay. I could open it easily. I can get into it with no problem. So for me, it's not a big deal. I don't know why they would do it like that. I don't know why. I think it was ridiculous and completely thoughtless. Unless, you know, it was their strategy on having you buy other chain straps. So, but that's just, it's wrong. It's wrong. So anyway, so it's full now, and I just want to show you something else. Recently, I did, look, I'm just losing my train of thought. I did an unboxing of a chain strap that I bought from Coach for Pride, from their Pride collection. Trying to be quiet. And I did a collab with Yoda and Winnie, so I will link that channel down below if you're interested in seeing it. This is the chain strap. When, look at this, I keep slapping it all over, sorry. When Yoda showed what she uses it for, she put this on, I think, two of her Fendi bags. You'll see if you check out her video. So I didn't bring the Fendi to check to see how it would look with this chain strap. So I'm gonna do that right now because I'm curious to see how it's gonna look. This is definitely a shoulder strap. It's not made for crossbody. You could either hold it in your hand or on the shoulder. That's kind of nice, right? It's kind of nice. So let's say I was gonna hold this, it fits perfectly fine on the shoulder. Maybe I wouldn't keep the strap on if I was using the Coach. I think that might be too much. But let me see if I wanted to carry this on the shoulder and have it as a decoration. That looks pretty cool, right? I didn't think it would look so good on the Fendi, but it does. It looks good. It's the same color hardware, and it looks really nice. It's pretty cool, right? I'll show you again how that would look. Not bad. That's kind of cute. So I thought that would be really nice. I thought it would look really nice, and it actually does. Look at that. It's really great. This is one of the best purchases, I have to say. This Coach chain is just, it's beautiful. But I did want to try something else. Let's just say I didn't want to wear the long shoulder strap that comes with the Fendi because I wanted to, you know, lay longer as a crossbody. So I have this Coach chain. So I wanted to see how that would look if I put it on the Fendi as a crossbody. It's thin, but yeah, might look good. Let's see. So this is how it would look crossbody with this Coach strap. So it actually fits a little bit long for me, but it would work for other people. It's not adjustable, so I don't have a choice. So this is what it would look like if it was on the chain. I think this chain is a little thin for the Fendi. I don't really care for it that much. I think if I'm going to use a gold chain on this Fendi, it should be something that's a little more, you know, thicker of substance, like a big chain, like chain links in gold. So, but they're all available. You can find them anywhere. But I thought it might look okay, and it really doesn't. Tell me what you think. It's a little bit too skinny for this bag, I think, but it's also too long for me. So actually, most bags that this Coach goes on would be too long for me because it's just, the strap is too long. I got it on sale, it was really cheap. I think on the outlet for like $25. But maybe I will, if I'm not gonna use it, maybe I'll give it away at my next giveaway, which hopefully will be 2,000 subs. So subscribe. Now without the long strap, this looks really cute, right? This is really cute. What do you think? I like it with this chain strap. I think it's really pretty. And I always forget to put a towel down in front of me so the chain won't continuously make noise. Again, I haven't used this Fendi bag yet. I hopefully will. Probably not going to grab for it during the summer because I just have so many other bags that make a better, you know, summer bag. But I wanted to do the what fits for somebody who had requested it. So hopefully you're seeing this. It really holds a lot. It holds a lot. If I don't use the full key pouch and I just put my keys in, then that gives even more room. It holds a ton. There's nothing that you will have to carry that you won't be able to fit in this bag. It's a great bag. It's a great bag. It's a beautiful bag. I don't have any regrets that I bought this bag. I only regret that I have not taken it out to wear it. You know, that's a problem. I need to wear it. And, you know, maybe it's that whole mentality that I'm afraid to ruin it because there's no way on this planet I'll ever get another one, especially since the price has gone up already since I purchased it. So I don't know. It's just, you know, I used to do that with clothing when I was growing up. I would have tags on clothing and they would sit in my closet for like years and I would never put them on. Maybe because I didn't want to ruin it if I couldn't get it again. So I don't know. That could be a possibility with the bag too. So anyway, I just wanted to do this quick video and hopefully whoever requested that is watching. And now you know because you said you were thinking about making this purchase. And I highly recommend the bag. It's very expensive. But regardless of the price, it's a fantastic bag. Again, just remember that the crossbody strap is not really a crossbody strap. It's made for a shoulder, and if you're bigger than me and I'm small, it's not going to work as a shoulder strap. So, I mean, as a crossbody, I'm sorry. So anyway, that's it, and I hope you enjoyed this video, and I will see you guys soon. I am going to be doing another unboxing, hopefully by next weekend. Take care.